Happy day, toodly-oodly-oodly-oodly-lay, sing the song as you walk along. Hello, malt mumblers. Rafi here, and I'd just like to use this opportunity to highlight five blended whiskies which I suggest are better quality. Some of the emails I get say, Ralphie, what's the best whiskey? Answer, there isn't. There is no best whiskey. It's like saying, which is the best flower, best plant in the botanic gardens? It's like saying, which is the best castle in the country? Which is the best football stadium? There isn't. They're just different. So here we go. You'll notice a lot of the, what I'm mentioning here I've already reviewed for you in previous whiskey reviews. Now there's a simple reason for that. Being an independent whiskey buff, I don't get gifts from distilleries and I don't get paid. Any bottles that I do get as a thank you go to Glasgow's Whiskey Club, which lets me retain my independent voice, which is few and far between these days. So I have reviewed these because I've bought them out my own pocket with money that I earn from my job. And therefore you realise after your first blunder in buying something which was frankly crap, that you've got to be careful what you do. So here we are. Five good blended whiskies, starting with Johnny Walker Black Label. Quite pricey, quite expensive, but very much available wherever you are around the world. Do not pay more for that blended whiskey than you would for a malt. If the malt is the same price or cheaper, go for the malt. Next is Teachers Highland Cream. 45% Ardmore single malt, and Ardmore single malt is fantastic. Next is Isle of Skye 8-year-old. Small whiskey company, Ian MacLeod Distillers. Being small, it means that the people who actually deal with barrels and deal with whiskey tend to be also the decision makers, which is a good thing. They realise being a small company they need to be good to survive, and therefore you're seeing something of a reasonable complexity and consistently good standard. Black Bottle. Black Bottle is an amazing whisky for the price. There are whisky connoisseurs, so-called, out there who are spending thousands of pounds, hundreds of pounds on a bottle of whiskey, and they are not getting an awful lot better than this. Still one of the best crafted, carefully handled blended whiskies available. And finally, Monkey Shoulder. Interesting one this, because this isn't a blend of malt and grain, this is a blend of malts. This is a vatted malt whisky, mainly Glenfiddichy, Glenkinvey, and called Monkey Shoulder. And it's got its three little monkeys up there to give you a sort of clue, so-called. And it is named after a repetitive strain injury afflicted by the guys that used to turn the malting barley by hand. So there we are, the first whisky ever named after a repetitive strain injury, and hopefully the last. So there you have it, guys. Five recommended blended whiskies. Enjoy.